This is a Hot Pie original.
Taxpayers, you felt the love and patriotism when your political heroes passed legislation mandating the Curriculum Informed Patriotism Act, or IAP, as we like to call it. You feel the red, white, and blue, don't you? You feel it in your veins, but it's about to get better. It's about to get more patriotic, if that's even possible at this point, but get ready. What do your Cowboys, your Spurs, your Rockets, Texans, Stars, Express, your Houston Dynamo, your Austin FC, what do they all need? What does everybody need? Ask yourself right now. You felt pretty red, white, and blue. You felt like the Informed Patriotism Act would do it. That would take you to a patriotic place. So what do professional sports in the state of Texas, what do they need? Well, I'll tell you what they need. Those American-hating, kneeling, cop-hating, spoiled athletes, they need some effing patriotism. You have it. You feel it. They, by law, taxpayers, by law, they need the patriotism.
What? Over? Did you say over? Nothing is over until we decide it is. Was it over when the Germans bombed Pearl Harbor? Hell no!
Germans? Forget it, he's rolling.
It ain't over now. Because when the going gets tough... the toughs get going. Who's with me? Let's go. Come on.
So it's time for you to get on your feet, wherever you are, whatever you're doing. Get on your damn feet, people of Texas, because it is time. Disrespecting the red, white, and blue has gone on too long. What the American-hating, spoiled athletes, that's code for young black men, what they need? They need for the freedom-loving, flag-waving, Trump-ass-kissing leaders at the state capitol right down the road. They need, they desperately need, the only thing that's going to save all of us are the people at the capitol. They need them to pass another law. What you need, what they need, what we all need are more laws. Of course, when it's patriotic, you need more laws. Who could be against such a concept? This time, taxpayers, spoiled athletes, code for young black men. This time, it's for real. The people at the Capitol, so you can fully appreciate this and let your friends and neighbors know and people around the country and around the world, the people at the Capitol right now, as we speak, they are the moral, spiritual, financial, electrical and patriotic compass of all people of Texas. You don't have thoughts for yourself. You don't have feelings for yourself. You don't have ideas for yourself. They will show you the way because it's what they do. We put them in office to be the moral, spiritual, financial, electrical, and patriotic leader that they are. So that's why they do stuff like this. So you better put your hand over your heart. I know you're not a professional athlete. Far from it. Doesn't matter. By law, it's time to start. So put your hand over your heart. Newly signed Senate Bill 4. That's SB 4. Mandating. I said mandating, punks. Mandating by law. Mandating that the Star Spangled Banner be played at professional sporting events. And I would assume if it's not done already, I haven't been to a tractor pull in a while, but I guarantee effing tee you we're going to play this song at the tractor pulls and Molly Hatchet shows. Because the people at the Capitol are going to force those young black men to stand and put their hand over their heart, or else. I don't know what else, but something. Firing squads, who knows? What took us so long to get to this point, this freedom-loving, patriotic point? I might cry. I hope today someone cries. You know, I'd love to say I'm shocked at what I'm about to pass on. I'm not shocked about what I'm about to pass on. Law. Laws. By law. Or I'm going to assume, and maybe you have a better idea, I'm going to assume that you better do this. You better do this. Or firing squad. I don't know. Is that back? Probably is. You've got to be kidding. You've got to be kidding. No? You can go ahead and insert whatever North Korean analogy you would like, and I'm going to tell you right now, it's not going to be that far off. Here you go. Let me get my $7 glasses. Is anyone crying yet? I've cried twice. You ever sit back in amazement and appreciation of how you'd be lost without the people of the Capitol, wouldn't you? You'd be lost. You wouldn't. You'd be, it'd be crime infested. You'd be having sex everywhere. It'd be orgies everywhere. You'd be broke. Thank God they're saving you. You wouldn't be patriotic at all if it wasn't for them. All right. Headline from the Texas Tribune says Texas House votes to yank funding from sports teams that don't play the national anthem. What's it called? Well, we already have taxpayers. We already have the Informed Patriotism Act because we're going to stop these godless kneelers. Damn it. Let's get some laws going. I think we should require that you wear red, white, and blue. In fact, I'm going to submit, and it probably happened, that every professional sports franchise, every high school team in this state wears red, white, and blue. No more of these godless colors. So the Texas House gave final passage to the so-called Star Spangled Banner Protection Act. Yes. Yes, of course. How did we go so long without the Star Spangled Banner Protection Act? How in the world did we make it this far? No wonder we were a mess. Thank God, Dan Patrick and Greg Abadell. Thank you, leaders. Thank you. The Star Spangled Banner Protection Act. That would be the SBUT Act or something like that. And we don't have an acronym yet. We're working on it. We have IAP and now we have a SBAC. All right, Senate Bill 4 will be signed by Greg Abbott. You better believe he will, and he'll go right on Fox News afterwards. He'll sell that on Sean Hannity's show because the godless men and women playing sports in this state need some patriotism by law. Hey, I'm here with John McLeod. I'm the creator and founder of ATX Hot Sauce, and when I say that you started this, maybe not screwing around in your kitchen. Maybe, maybe. Not that far removed from screwing around in your kitchen. So talk about the creation, the process, the dream that came out of the pandemic.
It's from Austin, you know, from Texas. There's not a lot of hot sauces out there that are actually from here. There's a few great ones too. But, you know, Frank's and Tabasco and some of these other ones, you know, I want something that's Texan like me. It's different. And I think that's what Texas is a little bit about. That's what Austin's about. So that flavor first, without the vinegar, and then going into the heat after that, but not a blow your head off heat. If you notice, a lot of the hot sauces out there that you see are like Da Bomb or Death's Door, right? Yeah. You know, and they're just supposed to blow your head off when you do it, when you taste it. Well, that's not the kind of hot sauce that I'm making. I'm making a hot sauce for the everyday person, for the condiment for every single day. And that's why the flavor first, heat second is so important, that you get those flavors that nuances whatever food that you're making.
All right, order a box now. It's atxhotsauce.com, atxhotsauce.com. Okay, so who's this dude? Here's Gene Wu of Houston. Why don't you shut up, Gene Wu? You hate America, apparently. Gene Wu is a Houston Democrat, says, once again, we're carrying legislation that is openly and aggressively unconstitutional. You back off, Gene Wu. Put your hand over your heart. You listen to Lee Greenwood and you shut your mouth or else. Or else, Gene. You better get up, Gene. Stop with your constitution. BS like that, Gene. It's time to stand or else, firing squad. Does Gene Woo not understand who he's dealing with? Does he not get this, Gene? Star Spangled Banner Protection Act? You don't get it, do you, Gene? Jackass. I bet you Gene's standing at the Capitol right now, or else, I don't know, death? I'm not sure. Eaten by dogs? What happens? What do we do to the godless kneelers? Here's another representative, Felicia Crockett. I don't even understand why would we need to force someone into singing any song. Okay, Jasmine Felicia Crockett, you and Gene Woo, you made the list. You made the list. Yeah, we got a law, people of Texas. We got another law. We got a law that is going to mandate that we play the Star Spangled Banner at sporting events. Okay. Well, Jeff, how can you be against the flag? Are you a kneeler, Jeff? You must be a kneeler, Jeff. You're a godless kneeler. Shut up. This is absurd. I don't care if this hurts your feelings. This is absurd. So let me explain the reasons why. Out of risk that I will be labeled a kneeler, a godless kneeler who doesn't appreciate America and all the great things our leaders are doing. Who couldn't use a little patriotism, right? What could possibly be wrong with making this law? What kind of jerk would even argue against this? I don't know. What kind of fascist would even make this a law? Why are we doing this? So, well, you know why we're doing this. Because they can. There'll be no pushback. There will be a rock star parade on Fox News. That's why this is being done. But let me explain a few things about stadiums and how idiotic this concept is and how idiotic taxpayer-financed stadiums are in this state. The very people passing this legislation, the very people, the moral compass, the patriotic compass of the people of Texas, the centralized power of the state capitol, because that's what they like. They don't like less government. They like a lot more of it. They're the very people around this state, and this happens around the country too. The very people that are passing this legislation, that are advocating this legislation, are the very people advocating the taxpayers give the money to rich men so they can build these stadiums. You're building these stadiums, taxpayers, and the very people that are advocating this law were the ones advocating for taxpayer funds for the stadium. And the reasoning they give, it's idiotic. It's the dumbest investment you can make. Sitting there at the craps table, standing there at the craps table with me is a better investment than you giving away taxpayer money to help appreciate the asset of a rich man, advocated by the very gigantic, far-reaching government at the state capitol. They're the ones that sell this idea. Now, you're dumb enough to go along with it. You're dumb enough to vote for these morons, but they're the ones advocating taxpayer-financed stadiums. You know what they usually say? They usually say, one, quality of life. You can have quality of life without taxpayer-financed stadiums. Let me break it to you. They'll say quality of life, but what it's really about, to understand what this is really about, this is, first of all, this is about two things. Black men kneeling, which you really don't even notice anymore. And number two, Mark Cuban. It's in support of old white owners. Old white owners. So this is about the Jones family and his taxpayer-financed stadium there at AT&T and the ass-kissing by the politicians. It's about the McNair family who run the worst franchise in all of sports, the Houston Texans. It's about the Holt family and the Spurs because those are older white people and they're good. Mark Cuban, not so good. Rich and smart, not so good. So that's what this is about. No, this is about votes. This is hypocrisy. This is an overreach. And it's mainly about patting someone on the back because Jerry Jones is fine with this. The McNairs and their horrific franchise, they're fine with this. The whole family and all their money, they're fine with this. Somebody somewhere driving around in the States, somebody somewhere watching Fox News thinks this is really cool. They'd also be the very same person that turns around in probably less than 30 seconds and says, yeah, they're for less government. I don't know. Ask yourself. You now have in the state of Texas the Informed Patriotism Act, and you now have the Star Spangled Banner Protection Act. What they won't do, even though they've threatened this, what happens? Not that anyone's going to do it, but what happens when? Let's say Mark Cuban, for example. Let's just say, I don't know, the owners of Austin FC, which is not a taxpayer-financed stadium. Let's just say somebody doesn't play the national anthem. What happens? They've threatened in the bill, overreaching, over-the-top, fascist-like bill. They've threatened... They've threatened to take back the money. Oh, yeah? Take back the money from whom? What do you do, walk around the stadium? You have some Dan Patrick in one of his shirts in the early 90s with fire on it and a Ranger belt? Is he going to walk around AT&T Stadium and say, well, it won't happen there because that's Jerry Jones. But are they going to walk around and say, you got to give me $5, each and every one of you? It's their money, you jackass. It's theirs. So they've threatened what? They're going to cut funding? Sorry, Texans. You suck now and you can't make any trades because we've cut your funding? What? Does anyone ever, when this stupid stuff is proposed, does anyone ever say, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? Some jackass at the Capitol who will be on Fox News in less than an hour. Some jackass at the Capitol said, we'll restrict funding. Does anyone ever say, oh, really? How are you going to do that? We've already given the money. The money is out. The stadium is built. There's a big structure right there. Your rich friend is richer. What are you going to do? Not let him have beer? I've cried three times. How many times have you cried?
Listen at JeffWardShow.com.